You've all received the official statement of what occurred at Stark Industries last night. There have been unconfirmed reports that a robotic prototype malfunctioned and caused damage to the arc reactor. Fortunately, a member of Tony Stark's personal...
Iron Man, that's kind of catchy. It's got a nice ring to it. I mean, it's not technically accurate. The suit's a gold titanium alloy, but it's kind of evocative, the imagery, anyway.
Here's your alibi.
Okay.
You were on your yacht.
Yeah.
We have port papers to put you in Avalon all night and sworn statements from 50 of your guests.
See, I was thinking maybe we should say it was just Pepper and me alone on the island.
That's what happened.
All right.
Just read it word for word.
There's nothing about staying here.
That's being handled. He's on vacation. Small aircraft have such a poor safety record.
But what about the whole cover story that it's a bodyguard? He's my body? I mean, that's kind of flimsy, don't you think?
This isn't my first rodeo, Mr. Stark. Just stick to the official statement and soon this will all be behind you. You've got 90 seconds.
Oh, Agent Coulson. I just wanted to say thank you very much for all of your help.
That's what we do. You'll be hearing from us.
From the Strategic Homeland and...
Just call us S.H.I.E.L.D.
Let's get this show on the road.
Yeah. You know, it's not that bad. Even though I don't think I'm Iron Man.
You're not Iron Man. You're not.
So, all right, so, you know, if I were Iron Man, I'd have this girlfriend who knew my true identity. She'd be a wreck. She'd always be worrying that I was gonna die. Yet so proud of the man I'd become. She'd be wildly conflicted, which would only make her more crazy about me. Tell me you never think about that night.
What night?
You know.
Are you talking about the night that we danced and went up on the roof and then you went downstairs to get me a drink and you left me there by myself? Is that the night you're talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Thought so. Will that be all?
Yes, that will be all, Miss Bonson.
And now Mr. Stark has prepared a statement. He will not be taking any questions. Thank you.
Been a while since I was in front of you. I figure I'll stick to the cards this time. There's been speculation that I was involved in the events that occurred on the freeway and the rooftop.
I'm sorry, Mr. Stark, but do you honestly expect us to believe that that was a bodyguard in a suit that conveniently appeared, despite the fact that...
I know that it's confusing. It is one thing to question the official story and another thing entirely to make wild accusations or insinuate that I'm a superhero.
I never said you were a superhero.
Didn't?
Mm-mm.
Well, good, because that would be outlandish and fantastic. I'm just not the hero type, clearly, with this laundry list of character defects, all the mistakes I made. Largely public. Yeah, okay. Yeah. The truth is, I am Iron Man.